Hello, it's Sunday the 31st of March 2013 and I'm Martin Smith, financial analyst at UFXMarkets Trading Support Center. This is your week in review. Today we'll discuss some of the major financial events of the past week and how they impacted in currency and commodity markets. The Japanese yen is headed for its longest series of monthly losses in over 10 years. The country's deflation could lead Bank of Japan governor to implement stimulus measures at next week's policy meeting. Mr. Kuroda, who will preside over the policy meeting, testified in Parliament this week saying that he intends to achieve the Bank of Japan's price target within 2 years. Japan's consumer prices declined by 0.7% in February. The Japanese yen was last trading at 0.46%, an increase of 0.05%. The euro rallied on Thursday as banks in Cyprus opened for the first time in 2 weeks. The orderly response of the Cypriot government to the bailout conditions boosted the euro, but the currency will remain vulnerable as long as the political turmoil in Italy continues. The euro was last trading at 128.19, an increase of 0.03%. Following reports that Australia is poised to sign a conversion deal with China, Fortescue Metals Group Limited, Australia's third largest producer of iron ore, said it welcomes any policies that promote the use of the Chinese yuan in international trade. Prime Minister Julia Gillard might discuss this conversion deal, which would enable the direct conversion of Australian dollars into Chinese currency during her upcoming trip to China. The Australian dollar was last trading at 104.08, a decrease of 0.01%. In commodities, gold posted its longest series of quarterly declines since 2001 after banks in Cyprus reopened, alleviating investor concern about the debt crisis in Europe and curbing demand for safe haven assets like gold. Positive data from the United States also diminished the appeal of the precious metal as a safe haven asset. According to the Department of Commerce, which released its findings on Thursday, the US economy grew at a faster pace during the fourth quarter than had been predicted. Gold was last trading at $1,594.28 an ounce, a decrease of 0.16%. Oil capped its longest weekly rally this year amid better-than-expected news about the US economy in the fourth quarter. Oil prices reached a six-week high in response to encouraging news about the GDP and increasing oil demand in the United States. Oil was last trading at $97.23 a barrel, an increase of 0.67%. Well, that's our summary of the financial headlines from the past week. We hope you've enjoyed this week's review and you'll tune in again tomorrow morning as we kick off the new trading week with the latest top market news. Until then, be sure to log in to ufxmarkets.com for all your trading needs and where your personal account manager is ready to answer all your questions. From the UFX Markets Trading Support Center, we wish you a successful trading day.